Students, in this video lecture, we will be studying banking. This is the second chapter of our commercial mathematics. This chapter is very important from exam point of view. In this chapter, from this chapter, we will be seeing almost I have seen every year they ask two questions. One is in section A, which is compulsory part, and the other question, it comes in section B, which is an optional part. So if you have thorough knowledge about this chapter, then definitely you will be able to score at least 7 marks from this chapter. So I will tell you, in this chapter, there are only two important formulas which will give you 7 marks if you practice it properly. If you read those sums, if you are able to solve those sums. Now, before telling you about those formulas, I will tell you the definition of banking, what are the functions of banking, and how they are helpful to us. Now, what is a bank? A bank is a financial institution which makes payments and gives you loan. Now, second, I told you, what are its functions? The bank has got various functions which cannot be dealt in detail here, but few things that I can tell you is a bank has got the very first small functions, that is very first function, not small, very first function is to accept our deposits and then give us some interest on that. Second, it gives us loan and then again they charge some extra money as interest from the consumer. Third, it has got facilities like transferring money from one place to another. Now fourth, I would say like traveler's checks, they provide traveler's checks. They also pays electricity bills, telephone bills, and various other functions which are being performed by the bank. Now, in this lecture, I told you a traveler's checks. What is a traveler's checks actually? Now, if a person from one country to another country if he visits to that country, he cannot carry those money in his pockets because if he goes to the airport, he has to do the exchange of those monies, and that money will again become a very huge amount for him to carry in his pocket. Now, for this, to overcome this, bank has provided a traveler's check facility. That means he will be having a small piece of paper that is a check type. It is a check only, and then on that every details will be there. And that if that money, that check, if he goes and deposit in foreign countries to any account of its country, SBI or suppose SBI bank or any Canara bank or any nationalized bank which have got the branch in that country, he can simply give those that check and can receive the amount. That type of check is called traveler's check. This is one of the most important facilities for persons who like to travel from one place to another. I hope all of you are aware about the credit cards and debit cards. Credit card is another way of taking loan from the bank on your name, and debit card is just an ATM that we withdraw the money from our own account as and when we require. So now it's time to tell you about the various types of bank accounts. There are generally 4 to 5 types of bank accounts. The first one I would say is recurring deposit account, which we are going to study in this chapter and for our method, for our ICSE syllabus. Now, second is term deposit. Third one is current account. Fourth one is saving bank accounts. Now, what is recurring deposit account? In this recurring deposit account is a type of account in which a person opens an account and deposits certain fixed portion of money in his bank account for a fixed duration of time. Generally, the money that he deposits is always in multiple of rupees 5, and the duration is generally in the multiple of 6 months. Now, second type I told you about term deposit account. In this, a lump sum amount is deposited for a fixed duration. To earn profit. Third, I told you current deposit account. This type of bank account is generally opened by business persons. This help them to have more money at the time of need. Then fourth one, I told you about the saving bank accounts. This is generally opened by all the citizens to keep their some profits to keep their some portion, to keep the some portion of their money in that account so that they can require, they can need at the time of their need. In recurring deposit account and in fixed deposit accounts, the money is being deposited and is fixed for that particular duration. One cannot withdraw money unless there is an emergency. Even if he is agreed, if he is ready to deposit, take out those monies from those accounts, then he has to incur a loss. The bank will charge them and they will deduct some money, some portion of their money, and then only they will get the money. But in case of current deposits and saving bank accounts, there is no such reduction in the charge. There is no such reduction in his money. He can ask, he can take as and when ever it is required. So these are the benefits that we have from these four types of banks. Recurring deposit account is like it is one of the type of fixed deposit only, means fixed duration is there. Whereas in saving accounts, it is not like a fixed deposit. As and when you want, you can just take out the money. Now some of the formulas that we will be seeing here are, as you must have seen, simple interest formula in the previous class. Simple interest is equal to PRT upon 100. This is very old formula that you must have seen. Now here we will be seeing interest is equal to PR n into n plus 1 by 24. Now if you see this t is replaced by n into n plus 1. Now we have to understand, we have to see how this n into n plus 1 by 24 has come here. Other than this, all these terms are same. Here in earlier case, P was the principal amount that one has to deposit, R was the rate of interest. Here, P is again the principal amount. Or in general, in questions you will see, it will be written as installment. Installments. Then we are having R is rate of interest. Per annum. Now, my first part that I want to explain you here is what is n into n plus 1 by 24 and how do we get this? From where did I write and how did I write this? Now, I told you this chapter is based on recurring deposit. So, every month, let us take an example. Example that a man decided to deposit rupees 100 for 6 months. He has opened a recurring deposit account in which he planned to deposit rupees 100 for 6 months. Now, in January, he deposited rupees 100. Likewise, in February, rupees 100. March, April, May, June. Up to June, he will be paying rupees 100. Every month he has planned that he will be depositing rupees 100, 100, 100. Now, if you see this 100 rupees, it is locked for how many months? It is locked for 6 months. Means in the first month of the year, he has deposited. He will get the money at the end of June only because he has decided to submit to deposit the money for 6 months. Now, this second money, second installment that he is paying, he will be fixing or he will be locking that money for 5 months. Likewise, we will be having 4 months. From here, we will be having 3 months. Second 100 rupees installment will be for 2 months. Then last installment will only be for 1 month. Now, in this case, now you see, if I have to say what is the interest earned by this man. So, interest will be equal to PR time upon 100. Correct. Now, P is how much? Rupees 100 he has decided to submit. Now, I am assuming that rate of interest was 5%. I am assuming rate of interest was 5%. Now, what is the time? 6 plus 5, 11 plus 4, 15 plus 3, 18 plus 2, 20 plus 21. 21. Then, it is in months. And as I have told you, this time is always in years. For our calculation, generally, we used to convert time into years. So, it will come out to be 21 by 12, and this will be 100% PRT upon 100 into 12. Understood? Understood. Now, if we simplify this, we will get 35 by 4 rupees this much as interest in 6 months, rupees 8, 3 by 4, that means 8.75 rupees he will be getting as interest. Now, I have to tell you that how we are going to add. If it is for 6 months, we have added 6, 5, 4, 3 on our fingers, we can easily add. We could have easily added. Now, if a person is depositing for 16 months, if a person is depositing for 16 months, 18 months, say for example 5 years means 60 months. Now, will it be easy for us to add 69, 59, 58, 57 and so on up to? It will be very tiresome and very difficult to add here and then convert this month into year by 12. Yes or no? Now, for this purpose, to simplify this calculation, we have one small general formula that we have found out. Now, let me tell you that formula. How we have derived that? If we have to add 5 consecutive natural numbers, 5 consecutive natural numbers, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 5 plus 4, 9 plus 3, 12 plus 2, 14 plus 1, 15. Correct? Now, if we see how many terms are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I write 5 and then 5 plus 1 by 2, 5 into 6 by 2, 5 plus 1 is 6, 2 threes are 6, that means 15. So, here also we got 15, here also we got 15. So, if I have to add 1 plus 2 is equal to 3, this is correct. If I have to use the formula, then how many terms are there? 2 terms are there. Last number is 2. 2 and 2 plus 1 by 2. That means it will again be equal to 3. If we have big numbers, then the general formula will be equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. Suppose I have a natural number series starting from 1 and going up to n. So, if I have to add, S will be equal to sum of all the numbers like 1, 2, some 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 dot 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 n minus 1th term and then n will come at last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 up to n and a number before that will be n minus 1 here. So, S will be equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus dot 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 n minus 1 plus n. Now, if I reverse this and write, again S will be equal to n plus n minus 1, then n minus 2, then n minus 3, dot dot dot, it will go up to 1. Yes or no? Just I have reversed because here n minus 1, so definitely here it will be n minus 2, here n minus 3 and so on. Now, if I add these two series, this will be S plus S is equal to 2S. 2S will be equal to N plus 1. In these two, if I will add, again I will get N plus 1 only. Here I will get 3 minus 2, 1. That means again N plus 1. And so on up to N plus 1. Understood? Now, you see N plus 1, N plus 1, N plus 1. How many times it is? How many number of times we have written? N number of times. So, this will also be repeated N number of times. So, to replace this, I can write n into n plus 1. Now, 2s, sum is equal to n into n plus 1, s will be equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. So, from here, so this is the method of putting the formula. From here, we got the idea that if I am having deposits every month, then I can generally write time to be equal to n into n plus 1 by 2 months. If n is in months, so definitely time will be equal to n into n plus 1 by 2 months. Now, if I have to convert, definitely I have to convert in year because rate of interest is per annum. If it is in per annum, so I will write n into n plus 1 by 2 This was in month. To convert this month into years, I have to multiply with the 12 in the denominator. So it will become n into n plus 1 by 24. Now with this, I hope you all are clear how we are getting n into n plus 1 by 24. So our formula becomes interest is equal to P R N n plus 1 by 24, and here it was 100. So finally we can write P R N into n plus 1 by 2400. This is our interest. Now maturity value, in earlier case in our lower classes we used to write amount is equal to principal plus interest, but here we will be writing maturity value, MV. Maturity value will be is equal to the amount deposited. So how much amount it was deposited? Installment into number of months plus the interest. Here we are having interest. So if I write, we can write PN plus interest will be equal to PRN N plus 1 by 2400. Now if I take out PN common, P into N common, then what I will be left? PN is equal to 1 plus R N plus 1 by 2400. PN PRN N plus 1 by 2400. So this is our formula for maturity value, or in local or in general, as you have studied in lower classes, this amount, this was called as the amount that a person will receive. Amount is equal to total amount, principal plus interest. Here also this is a principal value only. Each month he was depositing, let us suppose 100 rupees. For how many months? 6 months. So from the previous example, let me tell you, give an example that earlier he was depositing rupees 100 for 6 months. So if I substitute those values here, so P will be equal to 100 for how many months? 6 plus 100 into rate of interest, I told you it was 5. Then N was here 6 into 6 plus 1 by 2400. 0000 cancelled, 6 fours are 24. So this was equal to 600 plus here 35 by 4. That means 600 plus 8 rupees 75 paise, 608 rupees 75 paise he will be getting at the end of 6 month. How much? Rupees 8.75 extra. So this extra amount is called the interest that he has got while depositing rupees 100 for 6 month. So the only important formulas that you have to remember here is interest is equal to PRN N plus this much, and the second formula that you have to remember is PRN N plus 1. If you remember these two formulas, then you will be able to solve all the numerical problems related to this chapter very easily, and I hope you will be able to get at least 7 marks from this chapters very easily. Now question number 1 of this chapter, this exercise 2, says that Mr. Das deposits rupees 300 per month in a recurring deposit account for 2 years at a simple interest rate of 7% per annum. Find the maturity value of the deposit, first part. Second part, find the total interest he will earn after 2 years. Now what is his principal amount here? Question number 1, exercise 2, principal is rupees 300. Rate of interest is 7% per annum. Time is equal to 2 years. 2 years. So you have to convert this 2 years into month. That means 2 into 12 is equal to 24 months. Now why we have done this? Because in our formula, we were having... Now first let me tell you, find the maturity value of the deposit. So maturity value formula was MV is equal to PN plus PRN into N plus 1 by 2400. Yes or no? Now here N was represented in months. Never, you are not supposed to put N in years here. According to this formula,
You have to convert time into months, then only you will be able to use this formula. Otherwise, you have to use, if you have to use this years, then there will be some other formulas. So no need of going through that. You have to always convert time into months, and then only you will solve this. It is not like class 9th or class 8th numericals. It is in class, you are in class 10, so you have to use some different formulas by changing time into month. Now P is how much? 300. For how many years he is paying? 24 months plus 300 into rate was 7, time was 24. 24 plus 1 by 2400. So 2424 cancel, 00 cancel. Now you see 24 threes are 7200 plus 7 threes are 21 into 25. This will be equal to 7200 plus 21 into 25 will be equal to. So this will be equal to 7200 plus 21 into 25, which will be equal to 525. So final value will be equal to 7725. Actually, he has deposited how much? 7200. So this extra value is what? Is his interest that he received after depositing 300 rupees continuously for 2 years. Now, second part says that what is his interest? So this is his maturity value. What is the total amount? So I can say interest will be equal to, either I can write PRN into N plus 1 by 2400. We can use this formula and calculate, or else already we have calculated the maturity value. So I can write interest is equal to maturity value minus P into it, that is installment. If you see, this maturity value into this will be equal to this formula. Maturity value minus this will be equal to this formula. So I can write 7725 minus 7200 will be equal to 525. So in this way, you will be able to solve some of the questions and up to three or four number, and then you at least solve your examples that is provided in your book. I hope all of you must have understood this particular chapter, this particular segments of banking. So I would request you all to solve at your home, and if you have any problem, then you can ask me.